everyone.
Hi, Ripley.
So I've been told you have a weather station at your school. Who's going to tell me how it works?
So we have a weather station on top of our school, and we can measure what the temperature is, what the humidity is, how much rain there's been.
So you guys are clearly big fans of the weather. I've actually managed to get a special guest to come to your school today to tell you more. It's none other than the BBC weather presenter. It's Matt Taylor.
Hi, Matt.
Hi, all. I believe we have a great group of budding meteorologists here. Yes, but we're inside at the moment, but I think we're going to talk about weather. We need to go outside, don't we? Come on then.
We asked Matt for some top tips on how to predict the weather without any fancy equipment.
So you've all seen a flash of lightning and you've heard the rumble of thunder. Are they often together?
No.
Nope, there's usually a gap between them. That's because the speed of light is quicker than the speed of sound. And by measuring that gap, you can tell how far a thunderstorm away is. And you can work out where areas of low and high pressure are just by having your back to the winds and sticking your arms out. To the left is rain bearing low pressure, to the right is high. Watch the clouds and see which is coming towards you. If you look out today, you can see these are cumulus clouds, little fluffy cotton wool clouds. But if those clouds start to get bigger in height, they become cumulus clouds. If you start to see different layers of cloud, a thin layer of white, that's called altostratus, which as it gets thicker and thicker and gets really, really dark, can be called nimbus stratus.
So we've learned a lot today, haven't we, about how we can predict the weather with equipment, without equipment. What do you think was the best thing you learned today?
The best thing I learned today was the thunder clap.
I thought it was quite interesting how you could work out like the low pressure, where the low pressure was by just like knowing the direction of the wind.
I really enjoyed all the different types of clouds because I didn't know that there were so many types.
Matt, why is the weather so important?
The climate's warming, and in doing so, we're seeing more extremes, and that's the importance of understanding weather, knowing about forecasting, knowing what's coming. It's fantastic schools getting involved, whether it's a weather station of their own, passionate teachers. It doesn't need to cost anything. You can get outside, take your students outside, and just look at the weather.